No, I was over at my girlfriend's house. I was falling asleep on the couch. I was sitting there dozing off or whatever. And so she kind of just let me go ahead and go to sleep. I was just sitting on the couch, you know, like just sleep. And so what ended up happening was that I'm having a dream that is me, you, Ben, Righteous, Kalima, Third Eye, All the Black Ink, Sparrow, just everybody, every Detroit poet I've ever known in my life. And we're like at the at a bar, the Serengeti, some type of ballroom or something. And Miles Davis is there, Sonny Rollins is there, Cannonball Adderley is there, Gio Evans, Bill Evans, Sunrise. It's like everybody's like a big, humongous jam session. It's like little small cyphers in every corner of the room. You see Miles that being over here getting it on. And you see Sonny, Rollins, and Cassie over here getting it on. Then John Coltrane comes in. Door, they're like, hey, Coltrane. Sam's like, oh, man, hit this nigga, come fuck this, I'm gone. And so in my dream, I'm like, Sonny, you know, because you know, they had that riff, sort of kind of. It was like, Coltrane always outshined Sonny Rollins. He always did. And he even did little things, you know, with his album covers and songs, really try to, but it never worked. He always was seen number two, way number two. And so I'm loud on my couch, Sonny! Hey, Sonny! Sonny! My girlfriend comes in, Sonny! I was yelling that out loud in my sleep. So I'm sitting on the couch, hey, Sonny! She comes in, she sleeps, she wakes up, she be yelling, Sonny, where you going, Sonny? You can't leave, Sonny! Man, it was like the best dream I ever had in my life. Cause he came in, I'm telling you, John Coltrane came in with his K saxophone. So I'm like, hey, this nigga, come, I'm gone, man, fuck this shit. I'm like, man, where you, Sonny, where you going, man? Sonny! Sonny, where you going, Sonny? She come running, man. Who you talking to? Who's Sonny? Who's Sonny? What's he doing here? So I was at her place. Looking around like, I'm yelling, Sonny! Because if you're not into jazz, you don't get it. I mean, you kind of see it, the humor, but you don't really get the significance of having everybody in, Coltrane coming in and Sonny leaving. She don't get it because she don't understand the significance of Sonny and Coltrane at that time on the jazz. At that time, I mean, you know, Sonny and John, I mean, that was it. And John was way here. And every time Sonny thought he had the album that was going, John would just go way. And then he got with Impulse, it was just over. No way, but she woke me up, she's like, come on, get the bed. Let's see what the couch show, bro.
All right.